I'm Dr. Kelly Deal, Morris Animal Foundation Senior Scientific Programs and Communications Advisor. And I'm here today at Bell Carroll Animal Hospital in Denver, Colorado, one of our Golden Retriever Lifetime Study participating clinics. Joining me today is Dr. Missy Simpson, our foundation's epidemiologist, and Astro, hero dog number 11, to discuss something very important to our study, necropsy. Missy, I know this is a tough topic to talk about, but can you tell us what a necropsy is?
A necropsy is a postmortem examination for animals, like an autopsy in humans.
And why is it so important to the study?
Well, it may help determine the cause of death, which isn't always obvious. Second, it provides valuable tissues that we bank so that researchers can study them for many years to come. As we studied the association between genetics, environment, and nutrition in the development of disease, especially cancer, a necropsy is the final piece of the puzzle.
Okay, now as veterinarians, we know emergencies can happen at any time. What can an owner do now to plan ahead, even if their dog is healthy?
I recommend talking to your veterinarian now to decide where to have the necropsy done and whether it'll be a full necropsy or just the collection of certain tissues. This is also a good time to discuss what will happen with your pet's remains after tissue collection is complete.
Okay, that sounds like a good idea. What does an owner need to do when a hero dog dies?
Well, unless the dog dies at the hospital where the necropsy will be performed, the owner is usually responsible for transporting their dog. If delays are anticipated between the time of death and when the necropsy will be performed, it's important to refrigerate the body. Don't freeze it. And of course, your veterinarian can help you with body care if delays are anticipated.
Who can do the necropsy?
We don't have a preference for who performs the necropsy. It can be your primary veterinarian, a referred specialist, a veterinary teaching hospital, or a state veterinary diagnostic lab. The instruction booklet, which is contained in your necropsy kit, has all details about sample collection, even if a full necropsy isn't performed. One final note, please don't ship tissues or the body to Morris Animal Foundation. We can't conduct necropsies here.
You mentioned the necropsy kit and the instruction booklet. What happens if they've been lost or damaged?
Not to worry. An instruction booklet can always be downloaded or printed at caninelifetimehealth.org. Or we can always send you a new necropsy kit.
Okay, thanks. Do you have any final thoughts you'd like to share?
Just a request to our participants. Please consider having a necropsy, either full or partial, performed on your dog. We know it's a big decision, and you can always opt out at any time. But if you decide to proceed, it's the ultimate gift you can give to the study and to the thousands of golden retrievers your dog can help. We really can't do it without you.
Thanks everyone for watching. I hope we answered some questions for you about this very important piece of our study. If you have any more questions, please go to our website for further information. Thanks, Missy, and thanks to Astro.